So dear students, before going ahead, we'll have a recapitulation of the topics that we have read priorly in the previous video about this lesson of respiration for your syllabus. So see, respiration, what is respiration? I think by now you have learnt it by heart. Respiration is a biochemical process in the mitochondria of the cells where the available carbohydrate or glucose molecules are oxidized, that is broken, and they are converted again into their components, that is carbon dioxide and water. And as a result, what happens? The energy trapped in between these molecules is released, that is utilized by our body or the living body, right? So in other way you can write this, that respiration is a process of releasing energy from the chemical molecule known as carbohydrate. In another way you can define, what you can define, you see here, respiration is a process in the cells of living beings, in the cells of living beings, to release energy from, release energy from carbohydrate. Right? We need energy. You know, your TV set needs energy. Then what you do if your TV set needs energy? You plug into the wiring of the house and you supply electrical energy. Clear? Your cycle needs energy to go from one place to another. Then you pedal it. You push the pedals using your legs. So there you provide muscular energy to the cycle, then it works. Clear? But we human beings, we need energy. How will we get energy? We get energy not by connecting ourselves with electrical wire to the electrical sockets, is it? We get energy by this process, that is known as respiration process. Clear? And how this, what happens in this respiration? In the respiration process, this carbohydrate, from the carbohydrate is broken again into its components or the constituting substances, that is carbon dioxide and water, and energy trapped in between is released. Clear? Is that clear to all of you? So this is respiration process. And where from do we get this carbohydrate? This carbohydrate we get in nature as a result of photosynthesis. In the photosynthesis, what happened? The green plants, they absorb carbon dioxide from the atmosphere with the help of their stomata and lenticels, and water they absorb from the soil, and they combine them together, and they resulted the formation of this carbohydrate with release of oxygen. Excess oxygen is released from there, right? This was photosynthesis. Now before going ahead, I have a question for you. Now you tell me, to start this process of respiration, to start this, if I ask you to make tea, what all you need to make tea? Tea means the liquor tea I am talking of, the liquor tea that in the cup, the liquid tea that we sip in the evening sitting in our garden, right, or porch. So if I ask, I think many of you know, sir, to make that tea that we sip in the evening sitting in our balcony or in the veranda or in the porch or our compound, that tea is made by using some ingredients. So what are those ingredients? To make see this hot tea, this hot tea, to make this hot tea, what all you need, tell me. You need tea leaves, water, you need water, you need sugar, you need milk. So these are the ingredients we need to make this tea. Similarly, if I ask you, what all things you need to start the process of respiration, to start this process of respiration in the cells, what all things we need, do we need? So what will be your answer? You see, I will just write in a chemical expression of respiration, then it will be clear. This is C, C6H12O6. By now you know the name of this chemical compound. What is the name of this chemical compound? This is carbohydrate. This is carbohydrate. Or in simple way you can understand, or you can remember, glucose is the simple form of carbohydrate. Right? So this carbohydrate combines with oxygen. This is oxygen. Saying combined with oxygen is not a correct term, will not be a correct statement. Comes in contact with, it is not combining, it is just coming in contact with, right? When this carbohydrate comes in contact with oxygen, where? Inside the cell of a living being, and inside the cell in which organelle? In the mitochondria. In the mitochondria of a cell, then what will happen? After this, what will be the result? The result will be CO2 plus H2O, and we have the energy to carry on this process in our body. Our purpose, our need is this one. We wanted energy. This is our need, nothing else. What is going this and that is not our concern. Our concern is our body needs energy. Clear? This energy is required by our body. So you see, this carbohydrate, and when comes in contact with oxygen, then only there is possibility of respiration. So respiration, now if I ask you, what all components or substances you need to start this respiration process? So to start this respiration process, we need carbohydrate and we need oxygen. Do you follow? We need carbohydrate and we need oxygen, then only it is possible to start the respiration process. But where we need this? Will you, if you keep this in your pocket, will it go on? No. If you keep in the cooker of your kitchen, will it go on? No, it will not go on. Will you keep it in the refrigerator, then will it start? This carbohydrate and oxygen, if you keep together in the refrigerator, will it start? No, not at all. Clear? This chemical reaction will start only in the mitochondria of a living cell. Dead plants, they do not go on with this process, right? So essential things that are required to start the respiration process. Why do we, what is the significance, what is the use, what is the utility of this respiration process? Utility is that we need energy, but this energy is not available, but this carbohydrate is available to us. Carbohydrate is available, but we need energy. It is like the packet of that cake. You needed the cake, but it is packed. It is packed in a packet. So if you want to eat that cake, what will you do? You have to remove that packet, clear? So this is a packet in which what is there inside? Oh, not cake. Inside what is there? Inside this energy is there. This energy is there. And this is what we need. In a cake packet, you need the cake. Right? From the biscuit packet, you need the biscuits. You don't need the packet. Do you consume the biscuit packet? No. You needed biscuit. Similarly, we needed this energy. But this energy is packed inside this molecule. Which molecule? Yes, which molecule? Carbohydrate molecule. Right? So energy is packed. Our need is energy. This is not our need. We don't need carbohydrate. What we need? We need the energy. And for getting this, for obtaining this energy, right? For obtaining this energy, this is our need. This is our selfishness. This, our self need of energy makes us to initiate or start this respiration process. So what happens if carbohydrate molecules and oxygen molecules are available together? Suppose your friend is held by two very strong enemies. Your purpose is you need the friend. So what will you do? You will just dismantle this association, you break this association, the enemies you will remove and your friend will be free. Similarly, our friend, this energy is trapped inside this carbohydrate, right? Earlier this carbohydrate was like carbon dioxide and water available in the nature. This carbohydrate is present in the atmosphere and this water is present in the soil. From there, from soil, the plants took this carbon, this water, and from the atmosphere they took this carbon dioxide, and with the help of sun's energy they combine it together in the form of carbohydrate. Means they are the factories where they have packed energy in this packet. As the bakeries, they pack the cake in a packet, right? Similarly, these plants are the behaving like that bakery where they have made the cake and packed it into the packet, and you needed the cakes only. So see, this carbohydrate molecule is having energy packed inside this, but your purpose is you need energy. So, to reach to that purpose, you have to release the energy that is trapped in, and a long biochemical process takes place, and this process is called respiration. Clear? Now, you see, suppose I told you that this carbohydrate can be broken with the help of oxygen. Right? This carbohydrate can be broken with the oxygen only. But where will you find this oxygen? Where will you find? This oxygen is available in the atmosphere. Now I have a question. What is the total share of oxygen, percentage of oxygen in the atmosphere? Do you remember? It is 20.9%. Right, 20.9% of the total gases of the atmosphere is oxygen. Out of this, suppose in a simple way, 100 glass, out of 100 glass, nearly 21 glasses are full of oxygen. Other 78 glasses are full of nitrogen. Right, so this way, this oxygen is available in the atmosphere. Clear? If you see, if I remove this oxygen, will the process of respiration take place? Don't laugh. You'll be laughing, you'll say, sir, you said for this to break this carbohydrate, oxygen is essential. Just a few minutes before you told, oxygen is essential. Without this oxygen, there is no possibility of respiration process. Then how? If this oxygen will not be, will the respiration take place? Obviously, no. You are right. Respiration will not take place without the oxygen. Right? Without the oxygen, respiration will not take place. Then you have read that many microscopic single-celled life forms, they are found deep into the soil. If this is the soil, and some 20 feet deep if you dig, you will find one bacteria here. So what about this bacteria? This bacteria will not remain as a living being, because this will not get, this atmosphere is here. Supply of oxygen is here, but they are covered by soil. So this will die, will not get any energy. How will this go? Now a complex city arose. What is that? Without oxygen, there is no possibility of respiration. Then what about the life forms that are deep into the soil, where a thick layer of soil is dumped above them, and they are completely disconnected from or isolated from this atmosphere? They are not in contact with the atmosphere. Then where from will they get the oxygen to break this carbohydrate? Now a complexity arose. Clear? A complexity arose. How will they get the oxygen to carry on? Does this means they don't go with the process of respiration? Okay, let us think that if they don't go. If they will not go with the process of respiration, they will not have any energy in their body, and if they will not have any energy in the body, they will not able to carry on the vital activities of the cell or the activities of the cell organelles, and they will die. They will not remain as living being. So is it so that they come out of the soil, take oxygen, and then they go back and carry on the respiration process? No, it is not so. You see, in this compound itself, who is here? How many atoms of oxygen? 6. Clear? See this. Oxygen is already there. Right? Oxygen is already there. Sometimes you hear of one character in Ramcharitmanas. When we study about the Lord Ram's story, we hear about Vibhishan. We said, many people, or we have already a concept that Vibhishan only has given the clues to the opponent Ram, and that's why the great king Ravan was defeated. Is it? There is an, is not required to go deep. So means this character Vibhishan was in the Lanka only. Clear? Similarly, in this compound, you see, to break this compound, this oxygen is already available here. Right? It's available here. So sometimes in such life forms, this carbohydrate molecule C6H12O6, this splits of its own due to the action of certain enzymes. Enzymes, I have already told you, are chemical substances that start or initiate a chemical process. They start, they help start. Right? And this carbohydrate in such case breaks into C2H5OH, and energy is released. This is energy. Clear? This energy is released. So, don't be surprised. If I ask you a question, I have told you, that you had to burn this piece of paper. You said, sir, give me a matchbox or matchstick. When for the first time the fire was invented, you read in history, was it with matchbox or matchstick? Yes. Today you do one thing, Google in your phone or laptop and find if the first flame was invented with the help of matchstick. You will find your answer in negative. You will find that no, in the beginning there was no matchstick. Then was there no fire or no use of fire or flame before matchstick? Yes, yes, it was there. Even though matchbox was not there, then also there was use of fire. How it was? You may have read about the Stone Age in history. In the Stone Age, the human beings of those days, they used the rocks that was richly available on the mountains, on the soil. They used that rocks to make their weapons and pots. Weapons they needed to safeguard themselves from the wild animals, because those days human beings, they lived with the wild animals or other animals, and generally most of these surface of earth was occupied by dense forests, right? So whenever you read some history, you will find the reference of a jungle, right? So those days the human beings, they lived in jungles along with other life forms, wild life forms like the lions, the tigers, the hyenas, then so many wild, the wild pig, and then wild buffalo, then zebra, like, and some of these animals were ferocious or they were flesh eaters even. They used to trap the human beings and eat them away. To keep themselves safe, the human beings, they used the weapons and tools made up of rocks. So those days, incidentally, there was, we don't get a name with this of a scientist. If I say, who discovered the cell? Your answer is, sir, Robert Hooke discovered the cell. But with fire, we don't get any scientist's name or any inventor's name who invented the fire. It was incidentally invented because of an incident that the human beings of Stone Age, those days, they were making some, what I know I'm telling, I don't know whether I am perfect to the point, but what I have in my knowledge, that I am saying you. So they struck the stones with the stones to make the weapons and tools to protect themselves from the wild animals in the jungle. While they were striking the stone, it happened that a spark of fire emerged, came out of it, and that spark of fire, because of hot summer days, nearby some inflammable, very dry leaves or inflammable branches or substances were there, and they caught fire and they found this flame of fire, right? Clear? So we cannot say that the fire was not there or was not used before the invention or making of matchboxes, right? Similarly, you cannot say that respiration cannot take place without the atmospheric oxygen. Here you see, in the small life forms like bacteria and other viruses, bacteria and other say fungi, very small single-celled microscopic life forms, that are completely isolated from this atmosphere, they are not in contact with this atmospheric oxygen, how do they respire? They do not take atmospheric oxygen, but this they use the oxygen already available in the carbohydrate molecule, and this carbohydrate decomposes into C2H5OH, that is ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol and energy. But what happens in such case, there is a very small amount of energy is released. So they needed a small amount of energy because they are small, their need also is small. And how much energy is released in this respiration case? 28 kcal. This K is not indicating kilogram, remember. This K is, not kilogram, this is simply kilo we use for thousands level. Kilo, and this cal is not for Calcutta, the old name of Kolkata. So this cal is for calorie. Calorie is the unit in which we measure the amount of energy, right? As we measure the liquids by using the liter, if we express the amount of liquids in liter, the volumes, similarly we measure or we express the amount of energy in the unit called calorie, right? Now if you want to know how much heat is one calorie, then I can say that it is that amount of heat energy that is required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water by 1 degree Celsius, right? That is 1 calorie of energy. So here you see, in this kind of respiration, a small amount of energy is produced. It's because in this respiration, or in case of microbes, which are completely isolated from the atmospheric air, so they do not get sufficient oxygen and they cannot produce. So here you see, it is very clear that you have, this is one kind of respiration, and there is another one that I have told you priorly. What was that prior respiration process? Where there was availability of oxygen, clear? So with this, we come to know that this respiration is not of only one kind. We have two different kinds of respiration. Clear? We have two different kinds of respiration. So what do we call them? Right? One kind is this carbohydrate C6H12O6 combined with atmospheric oxygen and results in the formation of CO2 and H2O, and with release of energy, right? With release of energy. And in this case, the energy produced in this case is 674 kcal, right? 674 kcal. This is 674 calories. I have already told you what is 1 calorie, right? So here you see, we have this one respiration kind, this is another kind of respiration, and in both the kinds of respiration, they take place inside the living cell. That's why these are biochemical changes, and in the mitochondria of the cell they take place, right? But you see, some of the bacteria, they don't have the mitochondria. Then where? That's why, as they don't have the mitochondria, that's why they have this process of this kind of respiration. Now what is the name of this respiration? As this respiration is in contact with the air, where you find the air? In the atmosphere. So name of this kind of respiration is aerobic respiration. And what do you call this one? And this is not in air, opposite or negative of this aerobic, it becomes anaerobic. You have heard of plane in the air is aeroplane, right? Aero, so aerobic. Similarly, this kind of the second kind, the second kind of respiration is anaerobic respiration. Many of the books often say that when they distinguish, differentiate these two respiration, aerobic and anaerobic, sometimes they slightly deviate from the concept and they say this takes place in absence of oxygen, this takes place in presence of oxygen. That is wrong concept. Instead of that, you should say this takes place in presence of air and this takes place in absence of air. In absence of air, not oxygen, in absence of air. Air is different, oxygen is different. So always remember, if somewhere you find that it is written this takes place in absence of oxygen, is a wrong concept, because without oxygen there is no possibility of respiration. Oxygen is there, but oxygen of air is not available in second case. Here oxygen from the air is available, that's why it is known as aerobic, right? And this one is anaerobic. Means here availability of air is there, here there is no availability of air. But what is available?